Hi students, welcome to yet another session of my class. We are discussing The Fish by Elizabeth Bishop. Let us continue the topic. Yes, The Fish by Elizabeth Bishop. The fish is about, this particular poem is about a fisherwoman who tells a story of a fish that she caught. That is, here the speaker is our poet herself. That this poem is about a fisherwoman who tells a story of a fish that she caught. And it is important that the poem is in past tense, because the point of view is coming from the fisherwoman, that is from our poet herself, after she has gained appreciation for the fish. The main character in this story is the fish, but the narrator is the fisherwoman, that is our poet herself. And the poem describes how a fisherwoman's admiration for a fish can affect him. The fish displays her ecological awareness that leads her to accept a relationship of coexistence between human beings and non-human beings. Yes, the poem at the beginning is simply a narration. Yes, in the beginning of the poem, we can see that it is simply a narration about what happened in a particular day. That means the speaker narrates her catching of a big fish and other small fishes too. Yes, let us discuss in detail. First of all, I'll read the lines in, then I will explain you. The Fish by Elizabeth Bishop. I caught a tremendous fish and held him beside the boat, half out of water with my hook fast in a corner of his mouth. He did not fight. He had not fought at all. He hung a grunting weight, battered and venerable and homely. Here and there, his brown skin hung in strips like ancient wallpaper, and its pattern of darker brown. Yes, what do you understand from this particular, these lines, this particular, yes, poem, that is the fish. From the title itself, we can understand that this particular poem is about a fish, the fish. Yes, it is about a fish. I caught a tremendous fish and held him beside the boat, half out of water with my hook fast in a corner of his mouth. Yes, here the speaker or the fisherwoman caught a tremendous fish. Tremendous in the sense means a huge fish. And the speaker catches a huge fish while fishing in a little rented boat. Yes, and held him beside the boat. That is, she catches a huge fish while fishing in a little rented boat, and she studies her catch for a while. Yes, for some time she tried to observe that fish. She studies her catch for a while as holding it up, and she holds that fish half out of water beside the boat. Yes, half out of water with my hook. That means the fish is half out of water, and the fish is pretty old and gnarly looking. That is, half out of water with my hook fast in the corner of his mouth. That means the, yes, fish is the fish hung in her hook with my hook fast in the corner of his mouth. Then he did not fight. She observed that fish very keenly. He did not fight. She begins to respect the fish. He did not fight. Yes, this fish did not fight against the fisherwoman. He had not fought at all. He hung a grunting weight. And yes, this fish is old and gnarly looking, that is bad looking, with the barnacles and algae growing on it, and moreover, it is partially attached and hanging from its, yes, partially attached to the hook. And he did not fight, he had not fought at all, and he hung a grinding weight. Here, she presents the fish as a heroic warrior who has fought many wars and encountered many dangers. That means here in this part, she is trying to attribute human characteristics to the fish. That means she begins to respect the fish. She considers this fish as a warrior, brave warrior or heroic warrior. That is, he had not fought at all. He hung a grunting weight, battered and venerable and homely. Yes, she presents the fish as a heroic warrior and who has fought many wars earlier and encountered many dangers. That means she attributes human characteristics, that she considers this fish as a brave warrior or a heroic warrior who fought so many times earlier, encountered many dangers, and yes, battered and venerable. Here the fish is, we all know that the fish is still partly in the water. And the hook has not yet been removed from his mouth. That is still in the mouth of the fish. And here she, yes, establishes an interesting relationship between fish and the fisherwoman. That is, she is trying to establish a good relationship between that fish and the poet herself. And it is not a hook in its mouth. It is, she is attributing some human characteristics to that fish. That is, it is not a mere or a simple hook in its mouth. It is much more personal than that, according to the poet. And here the speaker has this tremendous fish that has put up no fight at all. And the fish is just hanging there, yes, from the hook without flapping around or struggling to escape from the hands of that fisherwoman. That means he has not fought at all. That is, the fish is just hanging. And it did not show any sign, or it did not fight against the fisherwoman to escape from her hands. And here the poet gives the fish human characteristics by referring to him as venerable. Venerable in the sense means someone who is very much respected. That means she is trying to respect this fish as a brave warrior, especially because of wisdom, age or character. And she also calls him homely. Yes, she also calls this fish as homely, meaning, yes, it is unattractive. Here the speaker has given us a kind of mixed feelings, that is mixed bag of characterizations and feelings about the fish. At one time, she called it as a brave warrior, venerable, battered, etc. And at the same time, she called it as homely, that is unattractive. That is a mixed, it's a kind of mixed feelings. On one hand, he is tremendous and respected, but on the other, he is kind of dead weight and ugly thing. Then here and there, his brown strips hung in, yes, his brown skin hung in strips like ancient wallpaper. Here, Bishop creates a simile between the old fish's skin and the, yes, faded ancient wallpaper. Here she creates a simile, comparison between the old fish's skin, that is, compare that fish's skin with a faded ancient wallpaper. Used, yes, ancient instead of the word old. Here she used, yes, we can use word old. This fish is seriously beat up to have strips of its skin hanging off. That means this fish maybe fought so many times earlier. As a result, this fish is seriously beat up to have strips or marks of its skin. And as a result of that fight, yes, some part of the skin is hanging off. And in the first time, yes, and it's pattern of darker brown and it's first time she is introducing color to the readers. Yes, we are introduced to the color of the fish that is brown. Maybe one more question may be asked, that is color of the fish that is brown. And this description, that is his brown skin hangs as strips like ancient wallpaper and its pattern of darker brown. This description certainly supports the homely description, that is she is that this fish is unattractive, ugly, or like a dead weight, that in the above sentence she explained. And this description, yes, we can consider it as a support to her above description. That is his brown skin hung in strips like ancient wallpaper. She compares that old fish's skin with a faded ancient wallpaper and its pattern of darker brown. And this is the first time she introduced the color to the readers. I think all of you understand this much. Okay, let us continue the poem. Was like wallpaper, shapes like full blonde roses, stained and lost through age. Yes, he is brown with a darker brown pattern, just like a wallpaper. Shapes like full blonde roses, stained and lost through age. Yes, here the speaker, yes, ties something traditionally to the beautiful roses to this homely fish. Again, she is trying to compare the skin of the fish with a beautiful rose. Shapes like that darker brown pattern on the skin of the fish. It is shapes like full blonde roses, stained and lost through age. Here its body was speckled with rose-shaped barnacles. He was speckled with barnacles. What is the meaning of the word barnacles? Barnacles means sea creatures that attach themselves to the body of the injured fish and appear like spots. That means as a result of so many fight, his body was injured. And some part of the skin was hanging from its body. So sea creatures that attach themselves to the body of the injured fish and appear like spots. That is the meaning of the word barnacles. So that full blonde, that brown skin, it is shapes like full blonde roses. Here the speaker ties that is or establishedly a comparison between that brown pattern on the skin of the fish to the full blonde roses, that is the beautiful roses, to this homely, beat up, yes, shredded skin of old fish. And this fish has got some serious pattern and texture combos going on. That is the appearance of the fish is here, she is trying to explain. Yes, that outer part, that outer skin of the outer appearance of that fish is here, she is trying to explain. His body was speckled with a rose-shaped barnacles and was infected with a tiny white sea slice. Yes, a darker brown pattern was like wallpaper and shapes like full-blown roses, stained and lost through age. Its color, its beauty was lost through age because our fish is an old one. And he was speckled with barnacles, fine rosettes of lime, infected with tiny whites and infested with tiny white sea lice. And from all these descriptions, we can understand that how old this fish is. And rosettes, in the sense, rosettes of lime. Rosettes are simply patterns or shapes that look like roses. By lime, she means the alkaline substance naturally occurring. So, totally reasonable to be an old barnacled fish like this one. She is trying to emphasize that our fish is an old one. Unattractive, homely. That's why she is using these expressions here. And the Fish might have lost the beauty of its skin due to its experience of, yes, withstanding numerous fights or numerous assaults. That's why in the above stanza, she called it as a brave warrior. Fine rosettes of lime and infested with the tiny white sea lice. And rosettes of lime means the lime colored barnacles look like badges shaped like roses. Sea lice means parasitic marine creatures that live on fish, because her body, this fish's body is injured so many times. And some parts of the skin is still hanging from its body. And sea lice means these marine creatures are the parasites that feed on fish that's attached to that injured part. And actually, this appearance is totally bad. Nasty, that they can, yes, eat or yes, sting humans too, because yes, its body is injured. There are wounds in the body of the fish, and the small tiny creatures are fast attached to that wounds. That was the appearance of our fish. And with the tiny white sea lice and underneath two or three racks of green weed hung down. Yes, the seaweed hanging from the fish that really supports the master of his environment. Again, she introduces another color, that is green color. Rags of green weed hung down. Here again, our poet introduces another color, that is green, into the poem. And color is important to Bishop in this particular poem, that is the fish. Yes. We readers are introduced with so many colors here in this particular poem. First one, we are introduced with the brown color. Second one is then, yes, white sea lice. Now, green weed hung down, and underneath two or three racks of green weed hung down, that the seaweed hanging from the fish. That is two or three racks of green weed hung down. Then while his gills were breathing in the terrible oxygen, the frightening gills. Yes. How dire the situation is for the fish. While his gills were breathing in. Yes. We all know that is the gills were frightening. While his gills were breathing in the terrible oxygen, the frightening gills here. Gills means we all know that gaps for oxygen for the yes, and the poet described them as frightening gills. Gills means an organ in the fish to for what? For breathing. It is the frightening here, frightening gills in the sense the bleeding gills that are cut by the hook, and that is frightening now. And from this expression, we readers can understand that how dire the situation is for the fish. The speaker is holding him half out of the water. And he is, yes, dying, actually going to die. His gills are frightening. Fish can't breathe out of water. And here, from these lines, we can understand the importance of time. Time is important here. A fish is going to die, and its gill is, yes, struggling, frightening, while his gills are breathing in the terrible oxygen, the frightening gills, because yes, that the gills are wounded. The bleeding gills that are cut by the hook are frightening. And the speaker is holding him out of the water. He is dying, and fish can't breathe out of water. And time is important, and the life of the fish is. Actually, the life of the fish is really in the hands of the speaker or the fisherwoman. That means she is still hung from that hook that is half out of water. Fresh and crisp with the blood that can cut so badly. Yes. This gills. It was wounded or cut by the hook. And now it is bleeding. These gills are bleeding. The bleeding gills that are cut by the hook are frightening. Yes, why his gills were breathing in the terrible oxygen, the frightening gills, fresh and crisp with the blood that can cut so badly. Yes, gills normally means gaps for oxygen, that is the organ they used for breathing, and it was cut so badly because still it is fast attached to the, or yes, hung in the hook of the, yes, fisherwoman, and struggling for its life, that is going to die. From these lines, we readers can understand the importance of time. That means the life of this fish is still in the hands of the speaker or the fisherwoman. It is struggling, going to die, because fish can't breathe out of water. So from these lines, we readers can understand that how keenly she observed that fish. Once she caught a tremendous fish, and she keenly observed the characteristic features or the appearance, and yes, she is actually trying to study the pattern, combo, texture, and everything, that is keenly observed. From this observation, we can understand that she was very much attached to the nature, and she was a keen observer of birds and animals for whom she had great compassion. I think all of you understand the first two stanzas of the poem. Let us continue the next session. And there is a homework for you, and the homework is write a note, that is the summary of the first two stanzas of the poem The Fish. Write your homework and send back to me. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you again.